little hiccup. This was a hard story. This was not a story about bullying, but this could have been a story about bullying. And my experience in Milwaukee and the work that I've done here is around the topic of bullying. Back in 2003, 2004, I was an English teacher in a large high school, and this was at the time, it wasn't too long after Columbine, there were stories in the news every day about children committing suicide, dropping out of school, and incidents like this across the nation. And I was seeing a lot of the same things right here in Milwaukee. I remember I had one student, LaShonda, who was a young African-American girl who was kind of goth, didn't look like all the other students at the school, had a lot of piercings and green hair and all of this. And the students would call her a witch and ride around on the broom and just be really harsh to her. And I knew her as this English student in the classroom, writing stories and really creative, and I loved the student. But at some point in the school, she blew up. She couldn't handle it anymore, and she just started yelling and threatening to blow up the school. And of course, it was taken very seriously. And it should have been taken very seriously. Did I think she was going to do that? I didn't think so, but could I know? I couldn't know. So she was expelled from school, or attempted to be expelled. She had to go through a hearing process, and her parents had to come in, and they had to decide whether or not she should be allowed to remain at the school. By some chance, she stayed at the school. A blessing. And I was determined to work with her to try to make this a different story for her. She wasn't the only student. I had a lot of other students whose similar things were going on. And I would have my students in my English classes write novels of their life stories. So they'd be writing a chapter each 6 weeks, and we'd be working on it, and I'd be getting to know them as people. And through their stories, I was finding out things about their lives that they didn't know about each other, and sometimes devastating things. But I couldn't tell them any of these things that were in these stories because it was confidential. I promised I would never share their stories. But there was also a lot of this ribbing going on back and forth, and sometimes to the point of bullying, and sometimes just crossing those lines. And I would know that this kid right here had been through so much in their lives, they could not handle one more thing. And I would want to stop it. I'd be like, you don't understand. You can't put one more thing on this person's plate. But I couldn't tell them why. So one day I had them do this activity where I gave everybody a little piece of paper, had them tear them up and throw them into a big box. And I had them write down everything that had happened in their life that was hard or that they were going through. And after they threw them all in the box, I handed each person a handful. And I had them just make a collage of all the things that they had. And there were things, my brother just got shot. I just lost a baby. My mother had AIDS. And things that you would have never imagined that my school students were dealing with, but I knew they were dealing with from their stories. And so as they created these collages, they got to see each other's stories without knowing whose stories were on the paper. And they would come to me and they'd say, who's someone? Did you notice? Did you notice? And I'd say, yes, I noticed. And as we got done with the exercise, I told them, I said, I know these things about you. And so when I see you hurting each other, it kills me because I know you can't take one more thing. And your peers can't take one more thing. And everybody at that point was about in tears because it was unbelievable to know each other's stories. And through that one exercise in the class, the students started treating each other kinder after that. The bullying stopped, the ribbing kind of stopped, and if somebody started, somebody else in the class would just kind of say, hey, don't do that, you don't know what she's going through, or hey, are you okay? And they started just having each other's back. And that moment, that exercise in the class changed everything that I believed about how to change the story of violence in schools. I believed that if you could get children to know each other well, they would be less likely to do harm. And at some point I came across a Buddhist quote that said, if you can see yourself in others, you can harm. this was at the same time that Bill Gates was starting schools in Milwaukee. So we got together a group of teachers and we said, what if we start a school that has a mission of anti-bullying and teaching others to do the same? And we do it by getting people to know each other well. And here we are, it's 11 years later and the school is going strong. And my hope and the work that we're doing now is that our students can teach other people to share their stories so that there's less stories like this in the news,